playoffs, and we have such a hard county that I think we come into playoffs expecting to get right to states. But I think we readjusted a lot during the game, and they knew us as a team a lot better than we expected them to. And our group came out definitely a lot, like with a lot of knowledge with how they play, so that helped a lot.
You guys had that timeout, 16-14, after you scored to get the two-goal lead. What did you guys talk about right there? Because after that, it seemed to be really
We really just needed to readjust, like, with working on the basics, because we can work together as a team, and we just need to, like, readjust and decide that we need this more than, like, we expected.
Laura, what does it say for this program that you lost your head coach, your longtime head coach, lost a all-county goalkeeper, and you guys are still on a state final?
Well, I think Karen definitely left Caitlin in the hands of a, like, great team already, but I think that she left such a good legacy, and Caitlin's really stepped up to the plate, and we have definitely not gone downhill. We've definitely readjusted and figured out our own selves as a team more than just a coach.
Eva and Milleker can answer this. Just talk about you guys have been in so many big games. So even being up by six goals and Howard moving within one, there wasn't seem a sense of panic with this team.
No. Well, you always have to know. I mean, we came in knowing that they're a great team, and we knew that we could never count them out of the game, and we knew from the very beginning that it was going to be a tough game all the way through. So we just had to make sure that no matter what, we kept giving it our all and 100% and never let down that intensity, because they're obviously an amazing team, and we knew that they could make that jump really quickly. So we knew that we needed to work together as a team and just keep the energy up.
I think we had to focus on balancing the intensity and the composure aspect of the game, and we were fine. We can work really well as a team.
How important is it to not be just a one-girl team here where, you know, multiple girls can score hat tricks in a game and lead you to victory?
Oh, it's everything. The team is the most important thing in any sport, really. Because if you can never rely on one individual to make that team effort, because obviously they can just guard, like, they can take one person out of the game easily, but they can't take a whole team out of a game. So as long as we're working together as a team, I think we'll play our best lacrosse.
When they went on that four around there to make it from 15-10 to 15-14, what were they doing? Was it just the breaks? What was kind of happening out there?
Well, I think they definitely realized that we were getting more comfortable with the game, and we were getting too comfortable with the game, and they, like, really had – they definitely – we knew that they had the skills to do it, but I guess that they readjusted in their huddle, and they saw that we were relaxing, and they could take that from us, and we just had to adjust to that.
Is that kind of a bit of a wake-up call going into the game?
I don't think it was a wake-up call, because we knew coming into the game again that they were an amazing team. And I think we just kind of let our guard down a little bit, and that's never good against a team like this, because obviously they came back really quickly, and so we just, like Laura said, we need to just readjust and get our feet back under us and keep playing hard.